Good evening, friends, and welcome to the Guy Shooting Range here in Maribor, Slovenia, for the last final of our time here, Skeet Men. I'm Hillary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having 1992 Olympic Games silver medalist in skeet and team coach for Chile, Mr. Juan Guija, here with me today. Welcome, Jan, and thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to work with you with this exciting final that we're going to have in some minutes.
It certainly is going to be exciting, as we have two Olympic Games quota places up for grabs, and four out of the top six contenders are eligible to win them. So we have a little bit extra stress on their shoulders. The two who have already won are George Arkeleos and also Tori Brovald for Norway. But all the others are up and getting ready to fight it out for these two quota places. The weather is changing a bit here. It's clear, more or less clear. It's 26 degrees Celsius. The humidity is 39%. The wind speed is 13 kilometers an hour, and the wind direction is coming in from the north. Although I have to say, it feels like the wind may be a little bit stronger than that. It's picked up in the last few minutes, and that could play a little game here or there with the targets, I would think.
I'm sure it will, because actually, yesterday in the women finals we have some rain, and you were a little sad that you remember this.
We had more than a little rain.
Oh yes. Mm-hmm. But they were strong and they were fighting.
They were really strong. Oh, I was very, very impressed.
Exciting.
Actually. Yes. Very exciting. If you want to go over the event details for me, Juan, that would be fantastic.
Well, the distance, 4 to 30 meters. The gun, we use a 12-gauge shotgun, approximately 3.5 kgs. Cartridges, we have pellets of 2 millimeter, max 24 grams, 24.5 max actually. The clay targets, the diameter is 110 times 25 millimeters, colored red, and with 110 grams from 100 to 110 grams each maximum. Numbers of targets, it's 25, and they will shoot singles and doubles. The speed targets, the initial speed of the target is 100 kilometers per hour, and it comes in an average of 88.
Okay. We have the Cyprus team here coming on to cheer on George Arkeleos. They had also a banner day yesterday with Skeet Woman. Let's just go over the world record and the final world record. That was set both by Vincent Hancock from the USA. The world record is 125, and the final world record is 150. They were both set in 2007 during the World Cup in Lonato, Italy. I actually had an chance to do an interview yesterday with 1996 Olympic Games gold medalist Ennio Falco, and he was talking about why this competition is so important. So let's take a look at this interview and see what he has to say.
This is very important for us, for all the shooters, to make this competition in Maribor, because we have next month the European Championship in September, the World Championship in Beograd. It's a very important test for all, and we can test our good condition for this competition.
Well, that was interesting information from Ennio Falco. Let me just introduce the finalists today. In sixth place, coming in with 122 targets representing Germany, we have Ralph Boehm. He's 27 years old. He won the silver medal during the Junior World Championships in Lahti in 2002. In fifth place, coming in with 123 targets representing France, we have Eric Delaunay. He is 23 years old. Delaunay. He plays fourth in Zagreb in 2006 during the World Championships. And in fourth place, coming in with 123 targets representing Greece, we have Efthymios Mitas. He is 26 years old. He won the silver medal last year during the World Cup in Dorset.
The silver medal won in Dorset 2010 World Cup, Mr. Efthymios Mitas.
And in third place, coming in with 124 targets representing Cyprus, we have George Arkeleos. He is 30 years old. He is a world champion, a one-time world champion, and a one-time junior world champion. He also won the silver medal during the World Championships in Maribor in 2009. And he's a five-time World Cup gold medalist. And in second place today, coming in with 124 targets representing Denmark, we have Anders Golding. He's 27 years old. He won the silver medal during the World Cup final last year in Izmir. He also placed fourth during the World Cup in Lonato in 2010. And in first place, coming with 124 targets, representing Norway, we have Tore Brovold. He's 41 years old, currently ranked number one in the world. He was the silver medalist during the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2008. He also won the bronze medal during the World Championships in Zagreb in 2006. He's a three-time World Cup gold medalist.
In charge of this finals is Mr. Anton Eister from Slovenia.
Anton Eister is the jury member from Slovenia.
Mr. Boštjan Potočnik, also from Slovenia.
Mr. Bohan Potočnik is a referee, also from Slovenia.
Finals competition will now begin.
We're going to get this final started now. It's going to be a very, very tight final as well. As I was saying before, there's only two target difference between first and sixth place, and three are tied up for first place with 124 targets. We've got two with 123 and one with 122. And let me reiterate one more time, we do have these two 2012 Olympic Games quota places that are hanging over four of these men's shoulders. So what do you think about these finalists?
Well, I shall start analyzing that Eric Delaunay has 23 years old, so he's very, very young.
Mm-hmm.
From all the shooters, we have three shooters very young. Delaunay with 23 years, Mitas with 26, and Golding with 27 years. This is not usual. Basically, the average was between 35 to 37 years. At this time, we have only Brovold with 41 and Akileo with 30 years, so I believe the maturity of the shooters are getting really younger.
It's true. It's very true. We've got Bukham, who just cleared off the first station, and now we're going to be moving on to Delaunay. You know, once again, we have real veteran shooters who have a lot of experience going up against some new blood also.
Yes.
That you haven't seen coming into a whole lot of World Cups before.
We can say that Tore Brovold is an outstanding shooter from Norway.
Mm-hmm.
With 41 years, started competition in 97, and he won three gold medals in Beijing 2010, Acapulco 2010, and Athens 2004. If you don't count silver, three silver medals in Concepcion 2011, Kerrville 2008, and Kerrville 2006. So Tore is actually very experienced. And
yes, he is. Let's take a look again now at Delaunay. He seemed like he had a problem there. He stepped again.
Yes, I can see that. Now the referee is trying to organize, maybe there's a problem with the clayboards.
There we go.
Clearing the house, so now that will be okay. Actually, to avoid getting distracted, he comes out of the station and focus again and come back for competition.
And as a
it's
coach,
very important.
As a coach, you would say that would be a good thing
yes,
to be doing.
That's what we have to do, actually.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good thing. So you have to clear your mind and come back to competition. We can see that actually his technique is very clean. The timing, the first target is broken up to 8/10 of a second.
Mm-hmm.
And full concentration, full pattern on the target.
On now to Mitas.
We may say that Etios Mitas is 26 years old and started competition in 1999. His coach is John Loberdos,
mm-hmm.
and he won one bronze medal in Brno 2003.
On now to Archelaos.
Actually, Archelaos is one of the best shooters in the world.
In fact, this is something that we do know about George Archelaos from Cyprus. And yesterday, as we saw, Andreu, who entered into the women's skeet, only 15 years old, and ended up almost shooting a perfect final. It was really amazing to see. So it just goes to show you that Cyprus has an incredibly strong team.
Yes. We can say that Tonino Blasi started this work several years ago, and actually George Aquileos is one of the products from Blasi.
So we should take our hats
Italian,
off.
He's Italian,
yes,
coach.
Yes, Italian coach, and now yes, he's in Greece. I mean, in Cyprus.
In Cyprus, yes. We can see also Pierre Moyne there sitting, a big coach,
yes.
Great coach experience.
Sometimes I'm not sure what's more painful to watch, when the yes, you know, to see the faces of the coaches or to see the stress on the shooters' faces.
I believe standing back of the shooters.
Well, you know
painful.
This. You know this.
I can feel that.
Now, we were talking before, Golden now has cleared this first station as well. We were talking before that you are a coach for Chile, but you also have coached Mexico.
India.
And India.
Also from 2001 to 2005. It was a very nice experience. Excellent country.
On now to Brovold.
As we said, Tore Brovold is from Norway, mm-hmm. 41 years old. He started competition in 97. And Pierre Moyne is the coach. He's a very experienced coach, well known to have taken several gold medals mm-hmm. for Norway.
Well, as you can see, nothing has changed on the standings after the station one. We still have Arcelius, Brovold, and Golding tied up with 127 targets, followed by Mitas and De Lunay with 126, and Buhiam in sixth place with 123. With 126.
Actually, this is going to be, the difference is very short. Only one target between the first shooter and target and shooter number five.
This is
so.
But I mean, unless something drastic happens, you could be sitting here next to me for a very long time because we could go into shoot off after shoot off after shoot off as well.
Well, experience says that will not happen. The pressure right now on the range is very high. I will give you some hints.
Fair.
In 92, we were six shooters. We shot 200 targets. That was 1,200 targets total. We lost nine targets, over 1,200 in the qualification. On the finals, the same six shooters shot 25 targets each, times six, that's 125, and we also lost nine targets.
Really?
So
that
you can
imagine the stress
pressure.
And the pressure.
Yes.
Meet us now on station two.
The timing is perfect, you know, as a pattern. His focus is okay also. We can see he's experienced.
He's experienced, and these arms of his, I've never seen arms like that.
Well, we have to be athletes.
Of course.
Yeah, we need to
do a lot of training.
Yeah. Especially to manage the stress and the tension that this holds in focus. Because basically with tension and stress, the miscoordination comes. And in this sport, coordination is 100%.
Of course. Now, Arcelius, also in Sydney, won a World Cup medal this year. He won the silver medal, and that was after a shoot-off and ended up with the silver medal. Now back on to Golding.
We must say that Golden won two junior medals, mm-hmm. silver, in Nicosia and Zagreb. Basically, this shooter is not so experienced, but he has managed to come up to this level with Pietro Genga as a coach. Pietro Genga was an Italian shooter mm-hmm. for the Italian team, and he's also very experienced. Pietro Genga won European Championships and has two World Cups. I recall in Lima, 95 and 97.
Mm-hmm. Back on now to Brovold.
So, first miss comes. This happened the same to Tore on the Olympics, last Olympics, 2004. When he had to make a shoot off with he lost the same target.
And this is where there's no room for error when the scores are as tight as they are. You know, just if you drop one target, it can set you right back down to very low standings. He's now tied up with Dulene and Mitas for third place. George Alcaleos is in first place, tied up with Golden.
I will tell you that now pressure is going to build up. Don't worry, everybody, when the first misses come, everybody's going to be there.
Back on now to Boehm.
Another miss.
Another miss. You're right. You were saying that the pressure gets built up.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about the fourth station. The fourth station is where we often see that things really change. You know, that's where the pressure seems to be at it. And then also we see that after the fourth station, if you can make it through without dropping a target, then maybe you're feeling a little bit
more confident.
More confident, and then you can make an error on the fifth station because of this confidence.
Or maybe seven. That happens. Actually, fourth station now is 25% of competition. We have six targets there.
Mm-hmm.
If we counted the one round with A stations and skid, is 25 targets. Actually, in station six, four, you have six targets. So that's 25% of the competition. And especially, we shoot two doubles there.
Right.
Normal double and reversible. So this is a little stressing.
Back on to Arcaleos.
I'm very happy that the weather is calm.
Me too. I was a little bit nervous. I keep on looking over to my left because that's where the storm came in from yesterday. And the skies are very dark over to the left, but the sun is out. Then it's also going to be interesting to see how the shadows play on the field here because, you know, during this week, the finals have been taking place quite late. For the viewers that don't know, right now it's 10 past 7. It was scheduled to go off at 7:30 this evening, but we started about a half hour early. And so the shadows aren't quite as long
also
as they were.
Of the light.
Exactly.
We need good light to see the targets. You can see the orange of the color of the target,
mm-hmm.
with the light and also the powder, you can see it's very, very clear and shiny. It helps the shooters.
And in your opinion, the background here at the Guy Shooting Center, do you like it?
It's a good background, but actually there's a little difference in the colors in the background. So the dark green and green, dear green.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it happens not to help you. So that's why they use yellow colors normally,
mm-hmm.
depending on the eyes. Shooters sometimes prefer not to use lenses as probable. Obviously, the best lenses is the one your
the
own
one that
eyes.
Works for you exactly.
Your own eyes, you know. But actually, in some places it's prohibited, and then you need ear and eye protectors. So at least we have to take.
That's another loss for Brovald.
Yes, this places him in a very complicated situation. Actually, I believe he pulled the same problem in station 2 at this time, and this is tension that was growing. It's a pity.
It is a pity. It's a pity because he did not have that stress of having to win an Olympic Games quota place either for Norway. That he's already done. And so that extra. And there's a miss for Boehm. And he seems to be, unfortunately, seems to be the one riddled with having a problem when he's calling the targets. Either the speaker's not hearing his voice or...
Sometimes the level of his voice or stress or lack of dehydration could happen because at this time, because of the tension, you get dehydrated.
Right, right.
It happened to me in 1982. The sun was... 38 degrees in Barcelona, and actually That's why shooter must keep on hydrating in order to...
They must keep drinking water during the whole final, of course. Yes. And it has been very, very hot here this week. Less yesterday, a little bit less yesterday when the storm came through. But definitely the days before, it was just unbearably hot. And there is another miss. It's showing as a hit for our graphics right now, but we just have to inform the viewers that that was a miss.
But then the referee called as a miss.
Yes, exactly. Delaunay?
It was the high target for the reverse double. Actually, explaining to your friends, in this station four, where they are shooting, we have a high target. That means that comes from the high house on the left, then comes a low target from the low house on the right. That's why it's called high and low. Then simultaneously, two targets come out with a delay from 0 to 3 seconds.
Delaunay, that looks like they're calling that as a double.
Yes.
A double miss.
Okay, so from 0 to 3 seconds, two targets will come from the houses. And you have to break them before the limits. There are two limits. The houses are the limits of the range. So first you shoot the high target, then the low target, and the reverse double will be on the opposite. First shooting the low house target, and then the high house.
On now to Mitas.
You see the powder coming through?
Yes.
He stopped some seconds to wait that the powder comes out and avoid distraction. Sometimes when you shoot the first target and you shoot them very nearby, the powder may
remain in the air and obstruct your
view. Vision. Yeah, view, yes.
Just one more pair from Mitas, and he will have been shooting an amazing vinyl.
Concentration, you see, perfect. Now it's very important, as a matter of information, for a shooter to be ready before calling the target. And we can see that Mitas is taking some time. Obviously, there's some time from when the shooter in front of you comes out of the station. You have 15 seconds in order to come in, next shooter to come in the station, prepare and call for target. Okay, then there's another time limit of 10 seconds. After he shoots the first target, he has 10 seconds to call for the second target.
And you can hear probably a little bit of the wind picking up in our microphones here. So luckily the lighting has not changed, but the wind has picked up.
Now he's a specialist on these targets, the doubles. You're gonna see where he breaks them. They're very close by one to another.
They're right one on top of the other.
Of course, yeah. That's very difficult to do. Only George Aquileos, Ennio Falco, and a few shooters can do this, because actually it's the way they shoot the first target and analyze and check for the second one coming in. You can see the same thing on the reverse double for Aquileos. You see the two powders, one over another.
One over the other. Yeah. One on top of the other. Aquileos has cleared every station so far. And now we are going to go on to Golding.
Well, Golding is 27 years old, as we said. He started in 1999 competition, and Pietro Genga is his coach. Pietro comes from Italy, well experienced shooter and competitor.
Yeah. Now, you said that you spent some time also in Italy, is that right?
Yes. Of course.
Mm-hmm. Training?
We'll have to. Italy basically is the place where we have to go for preparing shotguns and training in the different ranges. You have the Lonato ranges.
Lonato range is very, very nice.
Very nice, of course.
Okay, last pair for Golding. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. And now on to Brovald.
I hope he's concentrated, but I can see he has a little problem there. He's not happy with the result.
No,
I'm sure.
No, I'm sure he's not. And I just hope that he doesn't get too down on himself about this.
Mm-hmm. I also hope.
And the last pair here.
Now I'm sure he's gonna break them. I can see that.
You can see it in his eyes, yeah.
Yes, I can see it.
Oh.
Oh no. Second target.
That's the second target. Yes. Went down from Brovald.
The focus was okay.
Let's take a look at the standings. Things have changed around now. After the fourth station, we have Archelaus and Golding holding on to first place with 139 targets over Mitas with 138. We have Brovald in fourth place now with 136. And Bookham and Dulani in tied up for fifth.
We know that Achilleos and Brovald have a quota.
That's right.
So these shooters are actually going to win these two quotas that we have on this competition.
And then after this competition, it's going to be coming up the European Championships, where some more Olympic Games quota places will be available. But it's really coming down to the line now to win these tickets to the games.
Oh yes.
And the pressure is on
we have
everyone.
To wait till the last target shot.
Of course. Dulani. Back on now to Mitas, who has, up to this point, shot a perfect final.
You see the time he's taking?
And that's one that gets
yes.
away from Mitas.
Oh, yes.
Back on now to Archelaus, who also, up to this point, has shot a perfect final. I always find it very interesting to watch Archelaus in his routine before.
Oh, yes.
He is methodical about every single move, even down to the blinking of his eyes. Everything is the same every time, and it works for him.
Well, you must be a coach, because actually you analyze these things. Actually, everyone should follow this routine. It's very important, because it's a mental and physical routine mm-hmm. coming together.
Back on now to Golding. Also Golding, who has shot a perfect final up to this point.
Excellent, yes.
Really excellent yes. shooting. You know, we were talking about Archelaus just a minute ago, about the whole routine. Also, Brovald, he has you can see his elbow, that he brings it down twice, and every time he shoots, it's the same. Watch, we'll see this again.
Okay.
There we go.
Yes, you're right. Well, what was the problem here? Maybe he's not ready. Things are coming to his mind, maybe. Or sometimes a bird or something. That's Pierre Moyne, his coach. He's suffering there and supporting him as usual. In station 5, he lost the gold medal to Andrea Benelli. In station 2, in the qualification.
Right. There we go. Tori Broervald.
100%.
Getting back in there. And we have Arkeleos and Golding holding on to first place with 142 targets. We have Metas in third place with 140, 139 for Broervald, Buchem, and Delaney with 138. And we're now on to the sixth station, Buchem.
Shot. Yes, beautiful shot. Good connection with target. You see he doesn't move. An excellent double. It's very important to keep the position. If you break it correctly, keep this position then and prepare for the double.
Now on to Mitas. Mitas, who is hungry for this 2012 Olympic Games quota place. All he needs to do is keep on shooting the way he has been, and that will go to him for Greece.
Everybody's expecting a good result. Very good.
Back now on to Arkeleos.
Excellent hit. Good focus and concentration. Balance. Final initial barrel position. And now calling for target.
Once again, one right over the other. It really is amazing to watch.
Of course. His technique is outstanding.
Golding, who is fighting out for the not only the gold medal but also for one of the tickets to the games, shot a perfect final up to this point. It's really seems like he's just not stoppable. He's one to keep in keep our eyes on, I think. You know, the World Cup final he won last year, the silver medal during the World Cup final, and he just
two
seems
juniors
and two
in
juniors
in Zagreb.
Exactly, that was what during the European Championships.
With 27 years old,
Broervald dropping another target.
Another target. It's complicated, you know. It's a mind game.
Yeah. And I think that if your mind, you think about it too much, then. I guess there's no room really to think.
Sometimes it's hard to come back to focus.
And it's hard to watch also, you know. Arkeleos and Golding still holding on strong with 145 targets after shooting a perfect final. We have 143 going to Mitas. Buchem is now, and Dulani have now overtaken Broervald. Buchem.
Now we're in station 7.
Yes, we are. And this is, what do you think about the sun right now? Is it getting them right in the eyes, or?
Sometimes it happens between of the angle. I believe yes. But the sun now is not so strong.
No, it isn't.
Some other World Cups and World Championships that was more complicated.
Ooh.
Now we lost one target. My God, this target is not so complicated technically, but pressure works up. You
pressure
can see Achilles also there, breathing, mm-hmm. trying to pick up. Actually, that's very sad.
It is. You know, you can hear the comments in the crowd as well. People were really shocked by that miss by Mitas.
Station 7, my goodness. It's not a complicated area. Maybe the sun.
It could be the sun
in
their
eyes.
In
the path, and that happens. I've seen shooters like Achilleos change glasses in one station and coming back to another because of problems in the sun. You have to, before going in, you have to take care and get ready. You have to analyze all the situations before you go in the station. That's experience.
I think we can already say that Anders Golding has won one of the 2012 Olympic Games quarter places. Brova clearing station 7. I don't think that Golding can do anything wrong now. I think he's got that in his pocket. We have Archelaus and Golding still tied up with 147 targets. Mitas in third with 144. Vukam and Dulane 143, and also Brovald 143.
But Achilleos has a quota.
Yes, he does. So it's going to be going to Golding and Mitas. Yeah,
of course.
And this is what I think could have, you know, it could have been the sun on the station 7.
Yeah,
it could
sure.
have been the stress of having this for Mitas on his shoulders. Vukam is not going to be going home with the Olympic Games quota place, but has shot really a very, very good final.
Let's see. So the target, last target comes out.
Ralph Vukam. Moving on now to Eric Dulane.
27 years old, Ralph Vukam from Germany.
Yes. Dulane hitting the high house target, and now let's see how this goes on the low house.
He's the youngest shooter in the final with 23 years.
Unfortunately, also Dulane not going home with a quota place for France, but great to see him in the final. We have got the Denmark team has just run down the stadiums here, getting ready to congratulate their very own. Let's take a look now for Mitas. He has got the bronze and a 2012 Olympic Games quota place on the line here on the last shot. And there it is. Well, that shot. You can tell he is very thrilled. Now we have Greece that has maxed out their Olympic Games quota places. And fantastic work by Mitas. Bronze medal and a ticket to the games. On now to Archelaus. And he nails that squarely.
I can say that the six shooters, out of 125 each, they lost 10 targets in total.
In total.
And if we analyze the final, out of 25 targets, I believe they lost 10 or, or more. So this is the pressure growing up.
George Archelaus shooting a perfect final with a perfect 25.
Actually,
it's now
we're
on
used to it with Achilleos.
Yes, of course. But it's a little bit different for Golding Anders, who is now stepping up, and he has now got the gold and also the Games quota place on his mind right now. If he can clear both of these, he will be going directly into a shoot-off with George Archelaos.
Golding from Denmark, 27 years.
And there you go. Anders Golding winning a 2012 Olympic Games quota place and also tying up with Cyprus's George Archelaos for the gold. We will be going into a shoot-off. We just have to wait now for Tori Broval to shoot. Broval, who's, I'm sure, not very pleased with this final, having a little bit of difficulty.
We must say that Tori shot a 125, almost perfect score.
Exactly.
And he's an outstanding
outstanding shooter.
Oh, yes. The technique also is very good. But in competition, these things happen.
That's true. Things happen, and I'm sorry to say that for Tori Broval today. But now we're going to be moving on to a two-way shoot-off for the gold medal.
The shoot-off for the first place is between Mr. Archelaos Georgorios.
Now, the good part, the beautiful part about this is they already don't have to worry about anymore about the quota places. That's off of their shoulders. Now it's going to be, do you believe it's going to be that Anders Golding could feel a little bit nervous going up against somebody like George Archelaos?
Yes, but I imagine he shot so well in the final that I imagine he's going to keep on with the same mental attitude. But actually, well, Archelaos is very, very much experienced.
There's our bronze medalist our bronze medalist who is just being congratulated by everyone. If you could have seen when he first came off of the field, he was just being inundated by people coming up to him, hugging him, congratulating him, shaking his hand. He's the bronze medalist representing Greece, Efimeos Mitas. You know, and also with all this commotion that's going on down here, I'm sure that it's really important for George and George Archelaos and Anders Golding to really stay focused. They can't get involved in the, of what's happening.
Obvious. There you see Andrea Benilio on the left and Peter Jing on the right. Two great shooters.
Yes.
Andrea Benilio won in Athens a 96 bronze medal in skeet. And then in 2004 gold medal in skeet also.
Everything's set, and we're ready to get this shoot-off going. Anders Golding.
Excellent double. Both target broken.
Stepping up now, we have Archelaos.
Archelaos lost the second target.
Archelaos lost the second target.
In so short time.
This is
actually, they both shot very well.
They did shoot very well. Unbelievable. We have Anders Golding, who won the gold medal today. Let's take a look. There he is on our screen. In fact, this is the very first World Cup medal that Golding has ever won. And it's the shiniest one of all, so he must be very, very pleased with that.
Golding Anders from Denmark with a total score of
our gold medalist, Anders Golding from Denmark, winning not only the gold medal, his very first medal, but also a 2012 Olympic Games quota place. And here is George Archelaos from Cyprus, our silver medalist today. Let's see if we can get an image of him. There he is, George Archelaos from Cyprus.
It's very strange, but this happens.
Well, this happened also to him in a shoot-off in Sydney this year. And it was difficult to watch, to say the least. Juan, I want to say thank you so much for joining me today. You've been a book of knowledge for me, a wealth of knowledge for me.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. I really appreciate it.
I wish you the very best, and that once again, thank you.
Thank you very much. I hope we will have the opportunity again.
Me too. Perfect. Okay.
Bye-bye.